guys, Bikas over here and you are watching We Are Genius. Guys, today I am again with a new video around Arduino and ESP32. We'll see how to program the ESP32 modules by using Arduino IDE. Well, coming to ESP32, as you might be knowing, it is the latest release of Wi-Fi modules by Espressif, the maker of the popular and the cheaper ESP8266 modules. The ESP32 is a pretty powerful module featuring Wi-Fi, Bluetooth, both like classic as well as low power, dual core microcontroller at 240 MHz with one more ultra low power coprocessor. And along with that, it also features many more GPIOs and interfaces to interface external devices, which makes it perfect for IoT applications. The power management circuit of the module and the ultra low power processor makes it more power efficient and low deep sleep current consumption. I'll not get into details about this module and the features provided by it, and for that actually I have given a link down below in the description. So make sure to check that out before continuing this video if you are interested in. So being said that, let's get started guys. So guys, to start with this, we first need to download some tools for our Arduino IDE, so that we can program the ESP32 module from the Arduino IDE. To do that, let's get into github.com and we'll get into the official repository of Espressif, and that is the Arduino ESP32 repository. So github.com/espressif/arduino-esp32. And we need to clone this repository to our system. Again, for this, you can use the tool that is something called as Git. And if you don't have installation of Git onto your system, you certainly need to download it. And over here, I'm already having installation of Git onto my system. But to just show, I'll just get into this website, gitscn.com. And depending upon your like operating system, you just need to download the version or the build of the Git. So let's do one thing, let's close it. This is pretty simple. You can simply download and install it onto your system depending upon your platform. Over here, just copy this path over here, and on your desktop you can fire up the Git GUI, or you can fire up the Git bash. So if you are like using Git GUI, it will be a bit easier, but we can go ahead with Git bash also. And I'll just type in git clone and the copied URL to the repository, that is something github.com/espressif/arduino-esp32.git, and now hit enter and it will clone the repository to our local machine. And depending upon your internet connection, it might take some time. So just wait for it till it gets completed. Now, after the cloning completes, you'll see files like this, like course, docs, libraries, package, tools, and all those things with some other additional files. Now, over here, depending upon our operating system, we need some additional tools, but those will be downloaded automatically. And for that, we just need to run one application, that is something get.exe, and that is inside the Arduino ESP32 tools folder. So just run it. And I'll just run it to the administrator. Click yes. Again, it will download the tools, and it is actually solely dependent upon the operating system that we are using. So it might again take some time, and it will download around 100 MB of files. So just wait for it till it gets completed. Now, after like everything completes, let's copy these things into our Arduino installation directory. And to do that, let's get into our Arduino installation directory. And it may vary depending upon your installation and all. So I'll get into program files. So actually I have installed it inside this portable installation and all. Get into Arduino folder, and inside hardware create one new folder, that is expressive. Expressive, and inside it once again need to create another folder, that is ESP32. Now copy all these things or all this firmware and all files to this folder. Now we are all done with setting up the Arduino IDE. So let's open up Arduino IDE and we'll plug in the ESP32 dev module to our PC and we'll check if we are able to upload a simple sketch to the ESP32 module. Now in Arduino IDE, if everything went actually successfully, the setup and all, and the tools were downloaded, we can see something like, let's get into examples, and over here we'll see something like ESP32. And a whole lot of these examples, like SDXS, ESP32 SD test, HTTP client, and all those things. Over there, update, EEPROM, and all those examples. Actually, we'll get into those later on different videos, like how to use BLE or other things of ESP32. So over here, what I will do is I'll simply write one hello world sketch that will print some data onto our console. So to do that, I'll just initialize the serial port. So this is a simple sketch that will print the millis or the time the Arduino has been up for, or the ESP32 module over here has been up for, with 1 second delay onto the terminal. Now just plug in your ESP32 module and install the required drivers depending upon the module that you are using. And after that, just get into tools and select the development board that you are using. So I'm just using one generic ESP32 development board, so I'll just select this ESP32 dev module. But if you are using something else, you can certainly choose the others. Like there are varieties of board available in the market, so whichever you are using, choose accordingly. Now just leave other things as it is, the frequency, and depending upon the flash size, choose the flash size that you are having, and lastly the COM port that your ESP32 module is connected to. Now after that, just click the upload button. Let's open up the terminal, and you can see over here it is printing out the time, and as you can see over here it is working, and you can modify the sketch and upload anything that you want. And in meantime, you can just try to different other examples, those are available for ESP32 module. So that's all for today, guys. I hope you have enjoyed this video. If so, show your support, hit the thumbs up button, and don't forget to subscribe if you have not subscribed yet. So see you next time with my next video. Till then, goodbye.